Would you like to be able to record non-business transactions in QuickBooks Online? Well, in this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course, you will learn how to record cash transactions between the company and the owner. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When cash comes from the company's bank account, credit card, or cash box into the owner's non-business funds, the correct account to record this in is already in QuickBooks Online's chart of accounts. It's called Owner's Pay and Personal Expenses. Owner's Pay and Personal Expenses will show the total amount of money taken from the business cash and given to the owner for non-business reasons. For example, let's imagine on January 16th of 2020, Vonda withdrew $800 from the company bank account for non-business personal use. It's the same expense window we have been using all along, and the only difference is we're going to put on the line where it asks us for an account, the account we will now use, owner's pay and personal expenses. So, what will the result be in the trial balance after we record this January 16 transaction? Well, we know that the cash in bank will decrease by 800 and become 4,000 because that's where the money's coming from. And if the owner took out 800, it means for the very first time, owner's pay and personal expenses will show up in the trial balance for $800. Click New and go over to Expense. The date is January 16th of 2022. We can leave the payee blank because it's an owner-to-business transaction, and that's fine. However, the payment account, the account the money is being paid from, in this example, is cash in Chase Bank. And the money is going to the equity account or the account under account type equity, owner's pay and personal expenses. And the amount is $800. It's that simple if the owner takes business money for non-business use. Then we click Save and Close, and the results are exactly as what we expected. Cash in bank went down to 4,000, and for the very first time, owner's pay and personal expenses showed up in the trial balance for $800. Now, we can use this same account for non-business services. For example, let's imagine on January 17 of 2022, Vonda paid check number 1002 to Ned's Taxi for a non-business personal ride, $50. This time we will use the checks window, but we will also choose owner's pay and personal expenses. So what will be the result now? Well, if we are in fact paying from cash in bank, then cash in bank will decrease. You see this? It will decrease by $50, and that means we have $50 more that we took out of the company for non-business use. So owner's pay and personal expenses increases to $850. And that will be the result, or the correct result anyway, after we record the check. We click New, Check, We put the date as the 17th. This time we do have a payee because you're paying a third party. And remember, the money is coming from Chase Bank, but it is not going towards a business expense. It's going towards the owner's personal pay and personal expenses. And it was check number 1002 in the amount of $50. When we click save and close, you can see that cash in bank is exactly as what we expected, $3,950, and owner's pay and personal went up to $850. Let's double click that and see that the reason why we know the total money that the owner took from the company was $850 was because first Vonda took on January 16th $800 cash from the account. Then on January 17th she wrote a company check for something that had nothing to do with the company. So this is not transportation expense, it's owner's pay and personal. Now, what about when cash comes from the owner, personal, non-business money, and the owner puts that money into either the company bank account or the lockbox? The account that we record those transactions into is also already in the chart of accounts, and it's called owner's investment. So example three, let's imagine on January 18th of 2022, Vonda took $200 of her own personal non-business cash and put it into the business cash lockbox. We will use the deposits window and we will use the owner's investment account. Now, if we do this, what will the results be? Well, we know that money is coming into the lockbox. So the account that says cash on hand is going to increase by $200 because that's the amount that Vonda's putting in, and the cash on hand will become $500. And because that $200 came from the owner's personal money, that means for the very first time, the account called owner's investment will show up in the amount of $200, which is the amount that the owner took from their personal and gave to the business. So, very simple. Let's just click reports and trial balance just so that we can see the results immediately. Click new, go over to bank deposit, and on the 18th, the money that was deposited was not deposited in the bank account. It was deposited in the cash lockbox. And we can leave the name blank because it's between the owner and the company, and the account will be owner's investment. And the amount that in this case that was invested into the company from the non-business owner's personal cash, $200. Now we click save and close, and we can see the results are exactly as what we expected. Cash on hand has increased to $500, and for the very first time, owner's investment showed up for $200 that represents the amount of money taken from the owner and given to the business.